Oh, here we are. Brandon Dubinsky, Tory Krug. Looks pretty good. Charlie McAvoy and Colby Cave. Ron Donato, doesn't he look good? David Becker, Dad Pasternak, he looks pretty good. He got his hair cut. Tuukka Rask. No, there's Tuukka Rask right there. Brian, here's, look at this. Boy, is he a good hockey player. He did great today, too. Looks good. Christmas time. And there we have the kids. Cooper Vitecki. Is that how you say that?
I would say Vitucci, but...
Vitucci. Whitby Wildcats. There's a Whitby Wildcats. They look good. Dawson Marshall, I think he's coming up, too. And New Hamburg Midget Firebirds coming up. They look pretty good, don't they? And my jacket's in. And here's one right here. I said, now, who's left me that? Who gave me that? Hey, Savannah, some girl named Savannah. It was her. It was one of the
girls. Savannah looks after us. She is the one in charge of this whole floor, actually. But
she does.
Yeah, and that, are you upset? Those are nice. Somebody's
no,
making money.
No, somebody's making
doesn't,
money on them.
It's not your head, care. But it's definitely a mugshot.
Oh, no, it's me. It's somebody. I don't care.
The dumping.
Everybody makes money. All right. Now, I know you people say, oh, they're giving up the puck and everything. Watch what happens. Who had this here? This Americans had this on it. Dump in. Do we do it again? We'll do it one more time. You see what happens? Watch the guy and a little flick like that. Now, watch, do it again, Brian, if you would. It's a dump in. I know you don't like, puts it in the corner. He picks it up, goes to the point, and in the net. Look at the dumb head. Put it out the point. Nobody's there. There it is. Dumbhead. All right, let's go. What are we going to do now?
GTHL Cup. You have more from that.
I do. Boy, this is really something. Let me tell you something. The guy on the left is Daniel Brassard. I think he's a chief scout. And the guy next to him will be the number one draft, I tell you right there, Shane Wright. And that is Ryan Delcotti, I think. And then there's the head of the GTHL. And the guy on the left there. And there's the teams I don't show. You know who won, because remember the last time we did that? And we have one more. Now, wait a minute. This is they're going to have an award. And you remember the kid. It was Roy.
Roy Pechenovsky?
Ben Pechenovsky. Tough name to say. And there's it. And he would be playing in that game, but he was murdered. And they're going to have an award for him and honor him because he was a great kid and a great goalie. I saw him play. And he'd be in that game today. God love him.
So Shane Wright, the guy was in the black uniform there.
And Monty, too. But the guy on the left plays just like Crosby.
Yeah.
And I know I shouldn't do that because I did that once before. Then all the kids started to pick on him and started, number one, all that. Anyhow, let's go.
What a story this week. Carter Hart got into his first game in the NHL and he won it with his family there. It was magical. But he got beat today. What happened here?
Well, he didn't have much of a chance today. I'll show you one of the face-offs. Look at that. Watch the bing, bang, in. No goalie has a chance. But hold it. I'm going to show you. This is the way goaltenders. See the setup? See the guy here? See the defenseman move? Is the right-hand shot, right-hand shot. See the draw? Left hand. Watch what happens. It happens every time. Watch that. It doesn't go. Bing. He never had a chance. Couldn't see it right there. But it's too bad. I wouldn't have played him in that game.
Oh, yeah, right.
I would have played him on the road. He won two games. Played the other guy at home. And go on the road. He's got all the pressure on him, but... I start knocking coaches right now. All right, let's go.
Well, if you were coaching, you wouldn't have had your defenseman do this either. This is a Patrick Kane goal from...
Now watch Patrick Kane. He's a pretty sharp guy, this Patrick Kane. Now watch, he goes in. Watch the guy. We're going to show it again. See, he walks in. He should have scored. Now watch. Stop here. He puts a hand. He puts his stick in... Look, watch. Stick in two hands. You're done. Kane sees this. He can't go either way. Watch, he pulls it in. He can't go either way. And the puck goes in. The guy's got the stick in two hands. What he should have done, all he had to do was this. Like I've said a million times, if Kane wants to go that way, he checks him that way. If Kane wants to go this way, he gets him that way. Stick in two hands. Don't pay attention. This is the way you guy coming in. You take him out.
So Paul Byron in overtime today. Montreal won again, Don, against Vegas. But this is a Shea Weber blast that was...
Watch now. Look, your guy jumps out of the way, and it's easy for me. Now, we got a good shot of him black from the end. Watch him jumping out of the way. Now, it's easy for me to say, standing here, he's got a howitzer, and he's all wound up. I don't blame the guy for jumping. He was in the way. But I'll tell you what we used to do with Potvin. Potvin had, Dennis Potvin played for the Islanders, Stanley Cup winner. He had, I look like Napoleon here. But anyhow, what he had a howitzer just like him. What we did, we played out a little more. We never saw a shot. If that guy had been out 5 feet, he could have blocked the shot. So if you have a guy like that, I don't blame you for jumping. But when you have a guy like Weber, you got to play out on him. And next week, I'm going to show what I would have done with you had three goals scored. I'm going to show what I would have done if I had been coaching against Ovi.
Now, do we want to play a sound on tape of you saying about Carey Price's pads, or are we just going to show Carey Price in the red pads?
Never mind showing him get the pads. I said he should get rid of those clunky pads he's got. Look at it. He's got clunky pads. I said get rid of those pads. Get your white packs on. Get in when you're playing. Great. Make saves and the whole deal. Now, there he listens to me. He puts on the white pads, and he's back. He's Corey, as we know him in when we had the games and everything, and he's playing great now. Now, what I'm saying is Mike Smith, listen to me. I know you're listening. Get rid of those clunky pads. They look terrible. They make you look old and slow. You are fast. You were good. Put on the white pads and go back the way you were playing. Looks like, tell me that doesn't look clunky.
Yeah, well.
What?
It's not working. He lost again today, so.
Put the white pads on, you'll be terrific. All right, let's go.
Dave Newell, one of our all-time favorites. Bob Cole's favorites, used to come to Bob's golf tournament down in St. John's every year, and everybody.
Now, wait a minute. Let me set it up, okay?
Sure.
Now, first of all, I used to have a reputation when I coached Sharp Tresser, and I used to give the referees heck. And he just called for him. We're in trying to play in here. For some reason, he's out, go to face off. He's hold it. Call a timeout. And he came to me, and you'll see him going, wait a minute. He was, you know, when he comes over and he goes like this, and on TV said, look at that guy giving it to Cherry. Look at that guy giving it to Cherry. You know what he was saying when he was doing it? That's the sharpest suit I ever saw. Look, he's telling me right there. Look, he said, yeah, that's a sharp. I didn't know what to say. Look at Schmutz.
The players.
The players, they haven't got to hide. They're all laughing. They're laughing so much. Anyhow, don't I look sharp, though? Like, holy smokes. Gee, I look good.
You know, Don, Darlene, they were married 51 years. Lara, Aaron, Jessica are his daughters.
He's a good ref.
Look, you had him going there, too. But Dave, and he was cool, right? Under fire, there's nobody you would want in charge of Game 7 other than Dave Newman.
And he thought I was a sharp dresser.
And you are. And Merry Christmas.
Thanks.
And see you tomorrow on Rogers Hometown Hockey.
Oh, yes.
Mississauga, your town, with Hazel McCallion, too.
I'll be great there.
On the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.
Hazel, you're the best.